Hi, I'm Riaz. We're doing a little road trip up to Aviemore. We're going to go skiing. What I want to demonstrate is the practicality of the Tesla Model 3 and also look at its range, carrying a roof box as well. I'm going to put up a list of all the luggage that we've got in the car as well. So that's coming up now and you can pause that and have a look. We're heading up to Cairngorm Mountain Ski Centre there. It's a distance of 120 miles. Same, we're going to arrive with 27% of charge. We'll see how we get on because I'm sceptical that we'll arrive with 27%. I think we're going to end up having to charge on the way up, especially with this roof box on. But I'll let you know how we get on. Right, kids, we're all good to go?
Yeah, we're good to go.
Update on the journey. So we're about 71 miles into the journey now. We're going over something called the Pass of Killiecrankie. So it's been quite uphill. Efficiency's dropped, so we're now doing 302 watt-hours per mile. Same, we're going to end up there with 24% of the battery left. Bear in mind, this is a smaller battery Tesla. We've had it for over 3 years, so we've had a little bit of degradation on it as well. But I can talk a little bit more about that at the end of the video. I think what we're going to do is there's a supercharger in Aviemore. We're going to just stop off there and just top it up for maybe 10 minutes just to give us a little bit more of a buffer. If you have a look out in front, so not much in the way of snow, unfortunately. I think there's enough to ski on when we get to Cairngorm Mountain. But 6 degrees, quite mild for this time of year, and unfortunately there's just not much snow at all. I was reading an article recently that it's been a record for the least amount of snow in the Northern Hemisphere this year, this winter, so yeah, not good. Having said that, looking up ahead, there's a bit more snow. That's good. Okay, that's us arrived at the supercharger at Aviemore. We've got 30% of the battery left. We've done 283 watt-hours per mile. So I'm going to just stick it on charge for about 10 minutes or so. Let's use the facilities and then we'll carry on up the mountain. So we've been stopped for a few minutes now. You can see the car's charging nicely, 59 kilowatts. That's given us plenty of battery now to get up the mountain and back to our hotel. So I think we will unplug and carry on our way. In the meantime, the kids found a nice comfortable spot to wait there. Right, come on, back in the car, we're going. Us arrived in Cairngorm at the mountain. It is absolutely rammed. Actually, they've stopped selling tickets. I've never seen it this busy before, which is a real shame, and also lack of snow doesn't really help, so they're limiting numbers on the hill. Disappointing that we're not getting skiing today, but we've booked for a couple of days' time. That's the first available tickets, and we're going to go for a walk instead today. Thank you.
battle with vanity among my knees. A sudden change in everything. To know when I would leave and feel when I'm free. You found love, just a fantasy. Beautiful and lovely as a life could be. And I don't lose any sleep, honestly. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Check in before we leave. We're just about to get packed. We spent 5 days at the McDonald's Bay Valley Resort in Aviemore. We had a few fine days, so managed to get up skiing on one of the days, which was good. Managed to get some hill walking and stuff done as well. But it's a beautiful place, great for the outdoors, so we come up here quite regularly. So we're just about to get packed, and we'll see how the car does heading back with the roof box. Okay, that's us en route now. We left with about 98% of charge. Weather conditions are, it's 5 degrees, still really windy. We still got the aftermath of Storm Otto. There's quite a lot of debris on the road as well, and it's quite wet, so definitely not ideal conditions. We've got the heating down to 18 degrees, and we're doing about 60 miles an hour where we can. There's quite a lot of traffic on the road, so we are going a little bit slower than that at times. Okay, it is really windy at the moment, and we're feeling it with the roof box. Definitely makes a difference. Feel the car blowing around. So we're on a bit dual carriageway, so we're doing 70 at the moment. We've gone 28 miles. We started with 98% of the battery. We're now down to 74%. Initially it said we'd get home with 42% charge remaining. It's now saying that we're going to get back with 28%. We're averaging 370 watt hours per mile. So that's really, really high. I think the roof box is acting like a big windbreak. And also the fact that we're kind of still in the tail end of a storm isn't helping. So we're going into a headwind and we're going uphill. And it's cold, so really bad conditions for the battery. Just stopped off at the House of Brewer for lunch. It's halfway down the A9. It's got this fantastic shop as well. So this is the House of Brewer here. It's basically a big department store, selling lots of very expensive clothing and fishing equipment, outdoors equipment, that kind of stuff. One thing it lacks is any EV charging. I'm sure that's going to come because I've definitely got the space for it. But the food here is great, the restaurant's really good. Amber, what did you think of the lunch?
Delicious.
Yeah, I agree. That's us home, 111 miles from Aviemore. Let's talk about the efficiency of the car. It's really been a journey of two halves. To begin with, the car wasn't doing too well at all. We're doing 370 watt hours per mile at one stage. And that was due to a really strong headwind. We had the tail end of Storm Otto, which we're driving into. It was also really cold, it was 5 degrees. So the battery doesn't cope too well with that either. We stopped at the House of Brewer, had a nice lunch there. And then after that, the car's done really well. So 64 miles from the House of Brewer and it's 218 watt hours per mile, which gives a total of 251 watt hours per mile, or about 4 miles to the kilowatt hour, if you like to think of it that way. The roof box hasn't affected the efficiency as much as I thought it would. We've managed to keep the cabin clear as well of luggage. I think the kids have been quite comfortable in the back. In fact, we can ask them. How's the journey been, kids? You been comfortable?
Good.
Great. In terms of how fast I was going, I was sticking about 60 miles an hour after the House of Brewer, pretty much most of the way as well. It's single carriageway most of the way, so that is the speed limit, although there's a few sections of dual carriageway as well, but I just stuck at 60 miles an hour, and that seemed to be beneficial for the efficiency as well.
Okay, I'm going to finish off with talking about some of the energy stats and also total battery degradation for our Tesla Model 3. Travelling up to Aviemore, we travelled a distance of 109 miles, used 31 kilowatt hours of energy with an average energy consumption of 283 watt hours per mile. The temperature was slightly cooler on the outbound journey, around 5 degrees C, and I was driving it pretty much at the speed limit at all times, so 60 miles an hour on the single carriageway and 70 miles an hour on the dual carriageway sections, which there is about 30 miles on the journey. So given those stats, we can expect our car to travel around 159 miles in those conditions and at those speeds. On the return journey, although it started off really windy, the weather was a bit warmer and it didn't drive quite so fast. I was keeping it to around about 60 miles an hour at all times. Second part of the journey, we also had a tailwind which helped us. That all contributed to a much more efficient journey home, so we averaged 250 watt hours per mile, which would give us a total of 180 miles of range. I mentioned at the start of the video that I was going to talk about the battery degradation of our car. We bought our Tesla Model 3 in December 2019, and it's now February 2023, so it's more than 3 years old, and it's travelled more than 37,000 miles with an average energy consumption of 228 watt hours per mile for this distance. There are several ways that you can measure the total battery capacity for an EV. The way I've done it is by using the battery management system, or BMS, which uses the estimated range and battery percentage remaining. So this screenshot was taken at the end of the journey. It shows an average energy consumption of 250 watt hours per mile, giving an estimated range of 76 miles with 35% of the battery remaining. So to calculate the total battery capacity at present on this car, we need to times the average consumption by the estimated range and divide that by the battery percentage, and that gives us a figure of 46.9 kilowatt hours. Our Model 3 had an initial battery capacity of 50 kilowatt hours, so that means we've had a total battery degradation of 3.1 kilowatt hours, which as a percentage is 6.2% over the life of the vehicle. My understanding of battery degradation is that it's non-linear, and that the bulk of it happens within the early part of the battery's life, especially in the first year. Our intention is to keep this car for as long as possible, so we'll keep an eye on the degradation over the years. There are other ways as well to measure battery degradation. For example, there are apps which can give more detailed stats on the state of the battery, but these require an OBD reader, which I don't have. The most accurate way would be to charge the vehicle to 100% and then just see how many miles you can drive before the car stops. However, doing this is really bad for the battery and massively increases your degradation, so I won't be doing that. Just a few words on the practicality of this car. One of the things that's really impressed me is its practicality. We're a family of five and often like to take lots of kit with us on holiday. We used to own an MPV, which did have more space. Having said that, we haven't been constrained by downsizing to the Model 3. The majority of journeys that we do in it, whether it's my wife commuting to work or dropping kids off at after-school activities, don't need us to have all that extra space, and the Model 3 is one of the most efficient vehicles you can buy on the roads right now. It's not too big, it's a mid-sized saloon, comparable to a BMW 3 Series or an ID. A4, but offers far more luggage space than either of those two vehicles. It's also relatively light for an EV. We deliberately went for the Standard Range Plus, which has a curb weight of just 1,611 kilograms, so that's not too much heavier than a similar size combustion engine saloon. I personally think that large SUVs are overkill, especially when most of the time they're used for either commuting to work or the school run. As an example, the BMW iX has a curb weight of 2,440 kilograms, which is much more damaging to roads. It's also way less aerodynamic, so you're using a lot more energy to get around in it. I guess my point is that if you're looking at the most sustainable option, which also happens to be the most financially savvy option, then you should go for the smallest, lightest vehicle which meets your needs. In our case, the Tesla Model 3 does this brilliantly. Right, I'm going to finish up here. If anyone's got any questions, please put them in the comments below. And if you have been, thank you for watching.